Welcome to the video. If you're using a Sonoff dongle-E, then there's a good chance that you are running on the old EZSP version of the firmware that is no longer supported by Zigbee 2 MQTT. In this video, we'll show you how to upgrade to the new Ember firmware, which also works with ZHA. Now in this video, I showed you how to install Zigbee to MQTT in 10 minutes. And using a Sonoff USB dongle-E, which uses the EFR32MG21 chipset from Silicon Labs. But things have moved on. If you've been checking your log file for your Zigbee to MQTT, you would have noticed a warning message that has started to appear. This is because adapters using the EFR32 chipset from Silicon Labs, the EZSP firmware is no longer supported and has been deprecated. By implementing this new software, you are future-proofing yourself and assuring a smooth operation of your Zigbee to MQTT for years to come, as new devices that you wish to pair with Zigbee to MQTT will be made specifically to use this firmware. We'll be upgrading the Sonoff Zigbee USB dongle plus V2E to the Ember firmware while maintaining all your devices. Everything will still work as before, but now with a supported firmware. Now, one word of caution, this does not apply to the Sonoff Zigbee dongle P variant, which uses the Texas Instruments CC2652P chipset. So if you have that version of the dongle, then don't try and perform this upgrade, as it will fail. And for clarification, although this video is titled for the Sonoff Zigbee dongle-E, the product official description ID is the Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB dongle plus V2, as I know there is a lot of confusion over the naming conventions. So how do we do this? So first up, we'll need the new version of the firmware that's available from GitHub from our friend Darkest, the developer that bought us the firmware for thread support. Just note that if you've implemented that firmware, then you will not be able to use the Ember firmware, so it's one or the other, at least at the moment. Navigate to the link in the description. Now there are many firmwares listed on this GitHub site, and we are looking for the latest compatible version, which at the time of recording is 7.4.2.0, with a baud rate of 115,200. The full file name is listed below. Click on the link. Press the download button in the top right hand corner. Press save as. Select a location where your file will be easily accessible, such as the downloads folder. Now Darkest has made this process super simple and provided a web page that you can use to flash your Zigbee dongle-E. Navigate to the web flashing page, link in the description. Just make sure that you are using a Chromium based browser, such as Chrome or Edge. Safari is not supported. Now, since we are having to change Home Assistant, it's a good practice to take a backup. Watch the video in the pop-up above on how to do this. Now, let's quickly check the devices that are attached to Zigbee to MQTT so we have a baseline of the default state. In Home Assistant, navigate to Zigbee to MQTT on the left-hand menu. You can see I have a Sonoff temperature humidity sensor connected and online. Now, navigate to Settings, Add-ons, search for and select your Zigbee to MQTT. In the Info tab, press Stop. We can now safely remove the Sonoff adapter from Home Assistant and plug it into your desktop. Navigate back to the Web Flasher page. Scroll down the Web Flasher page until you see the Zigbee dongle. Now press the Connect button. A window should pop up saying that the web page wishes to connect to your serial port and list your Sonoff as dongle-E. If no device is shown, then it's probably because you don't have the appropriate device drivers. If that's the case, then watch the video in the pop-up above for instructions on how to install these drivers so that your dongle will show up. Now select your Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB dongle plus V2 from the list and press Connect. A progress window will show that the web page is connecting to your device. Once connected, it will show the current firmware that is loaded and the device type. Press Change Firmware. We'll be loading the firmware that we just downloaded. Select Upload Your Own Firmware. Now press Upload. Navigate to the version of the firmware that you just downloaded and select. Now press Open. The web flasher will confirm that the firmware is valid and appropriate. Now press Install. The firmware will be loaded to the Sonoff USB dongle-E. Once completed, press Continue. The web flasher will reconnect to confirm it is working. Although it says EZSP, it is reporting version 7.4.2.0, so it was successful. Press the X to close the window and remove the dongle. Now we need to reinsert the dongle into your Home Assistant instance. Don't forget, if you are running on a VM, that you may need to reconnect the dongle to your Home Assistant instance in the VirtualBox or VM. Navigate to Settings, Add-ons, search for and select Zigbee to MQTT. Now, dependent upon which version of EZSP firmware you are running, you might not be able to simply reconfigure your adapter and everything work, as there might be a conflict between the new firmware and the backup files. To overcome this, we'll need to run the new firmware but with the EZSP adapter configuration. Press the configuration menu. Scroll down to the serial section of the code and make sure it has the following entries. I'll put this in the description for ease of reference. If you make a change, then make sure you press Save. Navigate back to the Info tab and press Start. Now let's make sure that the adapter has started successfully. First, make sure that you have a green dot in the top right hand corner. Next, navigate to the logs. Make sure that you don't see any red text indicating issues. Also, search for the text that Zigbee has started. As a consequence of successfully starting the adapter using the new firmware, but still using the adapter configuration of EZSP, the backup will have been updated, so avoiding any backup conflict issues, or worse, having to find and delete the backup JSON file. Navigate to the Info tab and press Stop. Now navigate back to the Configuration tab. Scroll down to the Serial section. Find the variable for the adapter as EZSP and change to Ember. Now press Save for the section where you make the change. In my testing, you cannot just restart the add-on or even restart Home Assistant to get the adapter working. You need to restart the host machine. Navigate to Developer Tools. Check your configuration. Verify that the Home Assistant configuration will not prevent Home Assistant from restarting. Press Restart. Expand the dropdown. Press Shutdown System. And confirm with Shutdown. Once Home Assistant has completely shut down, reboot your host machine. When your host machine has restarted, start Home Assistant. Now navigate to Settings, Add-ons, search for and select your Zigbee to MQTT. If you didn't have your Zigbee to MQTT on Start on Boot, then press Start now. Navigate to your logs, scroll down, and make sure that there is no red writing indicating that there are issues. Now scroll down and look for Zigbee to MQTT has started. Navigate to Zigbee to MQTT in the left hand menu. We can now see our Sonoff temperature humidity sensor is working perfectly, and we have successfully upgraded our ZBDongle-E to the Ember firmware that is officially supported. Now all of those new devices that come along will hopefully not have any compatibility issues. Fingers crossed. I hope you enjoyed the video and your new supported Ember firmware. If you found the video helpful, then maybe consider a like or subscribing to the channel for similar content. And if you want to support the channel, then maybe consider becoming a member and getting access to early videos plus other perks. Until the next one, let's hope those embers don't catch on fire.